going to discuss about composite design pattern, real life example, real time examples, definition, and then in the next video we will try to implement a sample program using composite design pattern. So for now we will just try to cover the theoretical information about composite design pattern and using real life and real time example. So before that, this composite design pattern falls under structural design pattern, so which is one of the important interview point of questions. So this falls under structural design pattern. And then composite design pattern, the main category, the main motto of composite design pattern is, if our object can be represented in three structure, then it can be considered as composite design pattern. So you need to represent the object in three structure, So it, for example, we can consider diagram like this. So this is your object, this is your complex object. If your object can be represented in tree structure, then you can consider it as a composite design pattern. And then the second rule is, the nodes are classified, and the second principle is, the nodes are classified into two types. One is composite, and then another category is leaf. So this is called composite and this is called leaf. We will try to explain those things using some real life example. If you are buying any car, then the car would have engine, and then the car would have tire. For that engine, it could have made up of some electrical components, and then that engine would have some valves, and then that electrical components would have some electrical chips, and then that electrical component would have some transistors. And then this is some tree structure of some complex object called car. Here, if some operation can be applied on a leaf object, then that operation should be applied on other composite and other leaf objects also. So first, before going to that, first we'll try to classify the composite and leaf objects in this complex object. A composite object would be car, engine, electrical components are the composite object. The reason behind that is, a composite object is an object which contains, which would be having some child objects. Here car is having engine and tire as a child objects, and then engine is having electrical component and valves as child objects, whereas tire, valves, transistors, chips are not having any child object. So these would be considered as the leaf objects. So any object which is containing some child objects would be considered as composite object, and objects which don't have any child object would be considered as leaf objects. So your tire, valves, transistor, chips are the leaf object. If you perform some operation on the child objects, for example, getPrice is the operation, which is a method which can be applied on transistor object, chips objects, valves, tires. Here, this getPrice operation are being applied on all the leaf objects, then that operation should also apply on the composite objects called car, engine and electrical component. So you can get the price of transistor, get the price of the chips, get the price of valves, get the price of the tires, engines, electrical components, cars and etc. So here the operation which is applying on leaf object is also applying on the composite object and other leaves and other composite object, then this would be considered as a composite design pattern. So these are the two principles and rules that are needed for qualifying the three structure of an object into composite design pattern. There are various criteria, there are various use cases where we would use composite design pattern in real life examples to solve real life problems. We will try to cover one of those real life problems using Java implementation in the upcoming videos. So please stay tuned to this channel.